Hello, this is my arcade monitor from my candy cab. It is a Nano, I think it's pronounced that, it's N-A-N-A-O, MS-2931. This particular model is, or should I say, has all the on-screen display, so basically all the adjustments is done by this board here. So if I was to bring up the on-screen display, you can do all the settings and everything through the on-screen display. Now you can go into factory mode, which is, bear with me a minute, I'll try and do this one-handed. There we go. You can go into factory mode, which gives you more settings. Now I've downloaded the manual and I've read it, and I understand probably 80 to 90% of it. Some of it is a little bit foreign to me, but all this is brand new to me, so you know, I'm still learning. Now I've adjusted the monitor as best I can. Let me just exit, there we go. I've adjusted the monitor the best I can, as you can see here. It looks all right. It's still a bit of a belly here, so I've still got a few, if you just see there, look. So there's still a few settings. So I can bring the cross hatch over to the left a little bit, but so there's still a few settings I can tweak to adjust that. But one of the main things that's been really bugging me since I've had it, which is a common fault with these particular, or this particular model in monitor, I'm not quite sure about the MS-2930s, but the 31s, from what I've read, is the convergence, which I may be wrong in thinking or understanding, is basically where you've got reds, blue, I think it's green guns on that actually fire at the front here, that they're out of alignment. So if I show you there, look. A little bit, just trying to get it to focus, so you have to bear with me. So you see the blues out there over in this corner, try and get it there, like you've got the red, there you go, it's out there, look. So basically it's distortion. So when playing games, you know, I'm a bit fussy, especially when I had it in tape mode, switched around playing shooters. The bottom corners and the top corners were distorted, and that's obviously where all your score and your ships and everything else is shown. So anyway, after loads of research, there isn't a lot of information out there regarding this. I know on some monitors you can adjust it on the chassis, which I'll show you around the back in a minute, but on this particular model, from what I understand, there isn't any adjustment for this. So looking at other people's, you know, threads on UK VAC JAMA, UK JAMA webs forums, should I say, sorry. There isn't a lot of information. Now on YouTube, I was pointed towards a video by Craig's here again. There's a French guy that has this exactly same monitor, and he talks in his video about adjusting it all, but it's all in French. Now he did do a thread, which again was in French, but I did get Google to translate it for me, and I read it, and I understood, you know, a majority of what he was saying, but some of it was broken, the translation was broken, so I've been, you know, looking at other, you know, sources and going through it all, and I've managed to find what they call convergence strips. Now, let me just get over here out the light, see if we can focus. There we go. Basically, this is, I think, roughly 90 mil long, and at one end, it'll focus. There you go. There's a little magnet inside. It's not a very strong one, but it's strong enough to work in bringing back the alignment of these guns. Now that bit there is the like a double-sided tape, so obviously it's stuck to the strip, and then you peel off the sticker and stick it to the back of your tube or monitor, should I say. So it's not massive, but these things are here, are very, very hard to find. There's no one in the UK that can get hold of them. This was from America, and it was new old stock. He hasn't got very many left, but I managed to get hold of some. Now I did order 10, but he sent 11, so I guess one's a bonus. So what I'll do is I'll just walk around to the back and show you where this goes. You have to bear with me a minute. Right, here we go. This is the back of the monitor. As you can see there, look. Let's show you the focus. There we go. Hopefully you can see that. So there you got in the bottom left hand corner, Sega Enterprises Limited, and it's the MS-2931-S. And so this is the chassis, so the board in which controls everything. Like I say, I don't know the ins and outs of everything. I've got a bit of an understanding, but now basically with these strips, what you're supposed to, or what I've seen people do, is you've got a gap between the tube and this, I think it's this bit here, the yoke, and you've got a copper, there we go, copper there, look. So basically what I've seen people do is you slide it down and then you move it around, and it adjusts, or should I say realigns, the guns. I'm not quite sure what sort of wizardry is going on there, but I know that it works. Or should I say, from what I've seen, it works. So what I'll do is I'll walk around to the front again. Like I say, you push it down in between. I'll try and get a picture over the top where what I'm doing. And then you tweak it around, push it in and out to adjust it. So just walk around to the front again. So what I'll do is move my chair. Sorry if this is a bit long-winded or a bit boring, but you guys will kind of get the idea of what's going on once I start pushing around. There you go, you can see that gap there. Now that there is actually factory, so I guess that's where they originally adjusted the alignment. As you can see, there's a couple more there, look, and down there. Let me just get that out of the way. Yeah, so that you can see some more there, look. So what I'll do is I'll push that one in, just leave it there, look, and bring you around to the front again. Now you can see let me just, sorry about the shakiness, if I push it in, hopefully, in a minute, there you go, see that there, I'll just show you, is me pushing around. So you can see there, look, see, I'm tweaking it around. You see my reflection there? See? So it's working. You're basically supposed to get it so it's white lines. Push it further and pull it out. So basically it's going to take a while for me to get it right. So if I leave it up there and pull it back, it's looking pretty much like the same as the rest of it. Just a little bit out just there, look. So what I'll do is I'll stop the camera here and I'll try and give it a tweakage and then come back and show you what it's like afterwards. Okay, so I've been fiddling around for, I'd say, best part of 40 minutes to an hour with the Convergence strips. If I just show you what I've got now, you know, we've got a solid, I say solid, but we've got white lines. We've got a little bit of blue out there, but I've tried so hard to try and pull it back in, but it's just not playing ball. So that's on the right hand side of the monitor. I'll show you around the back, but you can see what I've done is I've adjusted the horizontal and vertical size just to show you, because you can obviously hear I can come out quite a bit, but what I've done is I brought it in just so you can see, you know, the gap and where the guns are firing. You can just about make it out there, look, it's just a little bit. But compared to what it was like before, I tell you, I'm really, really happy, and I'm impressed by, you know, what the strips have done. I know, just a little bit there, look. You know, I've tried so hard to pull that in. See, when if I get the blue gun or the blue colour there, if I get that lined up so it's a solid line, it puts the red out, so then the red comes down. So I've tried, but you know, without taking apart all of the yoke and doing all that sort of business, which I'm not confident in doing, I'm not, you know, say something that a specialist would have to do. But if I just show you around the left hand side back of the monitor, you can see I haven't stuck them down yet. As you can see there, look, they're just there at the minute. But you can see where I've pushed them in. And pulled them around. But like, the left hand side is absolutely spot on. I couldn't wish for any better, really. But it's just the right hand side, it's just as you come down there, you can see it starting to try and get a good picture, because obviously it's difficult, isn't it? You can just see it a little bit. It looks worse on camera than what it does in person. You know, my eye, looking at the screen itself, it's almost there. It's just a little bit out. But yeah, so if I take you around the back of the right hand side, a little bit more difficult to see. As you can see, I've done there, look. Look, so I haven't stuck them down. So I want to do that, you know, first off. But the tube itself is Toshiba. I've been trying to find, oh there you go, look, 2000, that's interesting because of January 2000, because that's interesting actually, because the stickers inside the cab are saying 22nd of January 1997, so there's a possibility that this monitor has been replaced. In my cab, so could be a bit lucky, I guess. I guess that's why I've got the later monitors, the later monitor, should I say, to the original 2930. I've given it a good dust because when I had the cab delivered, it's all in cling film. I had a The person I got it off of done a video walk around and a load of photos and looked all right in the, you know, I was happy with what he was sending me, but when it come here, it was like it's like he sent a little Japanese man inside smoking, and I've the amount of cleaning I've had to do, it still smells a bit. I'm getting there slowly but surely, but it's work in progress. That's why I haven't done a video on the actual cab itself yet, because you know, I'll do a proper in-depth walk around in my cab, and I'll show you pictures of before and after, and obviously with the video, it's you'll be able to see it. But you can see down in there, look, I dropped a strip, but I'm not putting my hand in there just yet. I'll wait until it's all powered down and everything. But yeah, round to the front, what I'll do is I'll adjust the size and I'll put a game on for you so you can see what it's like. So, back in a minute. Right, so there we go. We've got Final Fight on the go. Oh. Try and... because it flicks around so much. There we go. It's like... it's hard to tell on the... on the Yoda reflection. You can see it's... there we go. Yeah, I've adjusted the screen. Obviously, there's the actual monitor itself is curved, so it's a bit difficult to see, but what I'll do is I'll put another game on and I'll try and block out some of this light so you can see. Back in a minute. Well, there you go, you've got the Hyper Street Fighter 2 the Anniversary Edition playing. I'll get some close-ups in a minute just to show you the corners of what it looks like now. There we go, you've got it. So it's filling the screen now. But before, the corners were really distorted, really badly. If I move across, you know, it's 100% better than what it was. Like I say, it's just slightly out on the blue. You only just make it out. I don't know whether it's me or not, but the colours do look a little bit more vibrant. I haven't adjusted the colours on it. Like I say, it's just so much better. There you go, I'm just about done at the angle, it looks a lot better, doesn't it? So there we go. I thought I'd just, you know, because of, like I was saying before, there's a video on YouTube, it's in French. I thought, you know, I'd put my little bit out there. Please do, you know, take into account, I'm not a professional. I don't want to come across like I know what I'm doing. Although I've read about it, I've researched it. And you know, I've had a little bit of a play. I feel like I'm confident. I felt confident in doing it. So I may have said some things that are incorrect, but I hope you get the general gist of what I've done, and you know, before and after. So on that note, guys, I'll catch you in the next video, and there will be one coming soon because I've had a few bits and pieces modified and whatnot to fit in my cab, so I'll show you that. See you soon, guys. Cheers.